Testing, testing.
Your mic's on, so now we can get, now we're live. Okay, call the meeting to order, pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have approval of 2 month or 3 months meetings of worth of minutes, January, February, and March of 2021. And we don't need a quorum, I guess, to do that. Is that what you're telling me?
That's what I understand,
okay.
But there are five anyway.
Anybody have any questions with the minutes that Merle has sent out? I don't. So all those wanting to approve the minutes, say aye.
Aye.
Okay.
Okay.
My report for the planning board, we have one application tonight. It's for Osprey Landing. Again, I haven't really reviewed the application hard, but Gretchen has looked at it, and she's filled out something as far as our commission's concerned, so they can have it for the packet for tonight's meeting. We might as well talk about what you wanted to talk about right now. About Mike has a question about, I guess, they want to know the process of how we do our reviews for the planning board. Mike, you want to just say what your concerns are?
Well, okay, so the question is, the council's looking at all of 2021, and I don't know about any time before that, but clearly the police report, the fire department, and the environmental commission are the three typical agencies that are asked to comment on any type of variance that's being requested. And the statistic is that throughout all of 2021, and I'm going to say that there was something along the lines of 19 variances requested, and there were no comments at all from the Environmental Commission. Now, I don't know the details of those. I'm not sure the question is related to what the details were. One of them, of course, was the Jitney. The Jitney. I'm reading the thing on the Jetty Hotel. And so the question was, are there really no environmental concerns at all on all of these issues that are coming up? Are there no comments? And so my question was, well, what's the process? Are you, as a commission, reviewing these? Do you all have a chance to look at the applications and be sure you don't have any concerns? Gretchen indicated that she looks herself at a lot of them, because everybody doesn't have the chance to see them, because there's a limited amount of time in some cases. So my question here today is that a concern that you have less time to look at them, or are there really no environmental concerns with all of these applications?
May I speak to that for a moment?
Sure, go ahead.
Very often they're left, whatever documentation on planning board applications is left in the Environmental Commission's mailbox.
Okay.
And there was one time when I started just as secretary with the Jetty, Charlotte picked up the packet, and we were here together, and she quickly read through it, and she wrote concerns having to do with cars not turning their engines off, the delivery trucks not turning their engines off, and things like that, and sent that in. And I, you know, so it was last minute, but I know that the Environmental Commission did respond to that.
So, all right, that's perfectly legitimate comments to make. I think that's the kind of thing that we're concerned about.
Let me comment now as far as my liaison with the planning board. Karen Secretary of the Zoning and the Planning Board.
Mm-hmm.
She's getting to be very good at what we have to get to answer your questions. Quite frankly, most of the time, 9 times out of 10, every application that we get, I can't speak for the Zoning Board. I have no idea why, if there's any kind of a request from the Zoning Board for us to make a comment, I don't know. It took us a long time to get this established, to even that we could actually be a participant in the Planning Board applications.
Yeah.
Okay, so, I mean, it took us a while to get that. So now every Planning Board application, Karen does send out something to the Environmental Commission that we actually respond. It's a one-page response of what our concerns are. So every application now, we do that for the Planning Board.
Mm-hmm.
The Zoning Board, I don't know. But getting back to the process, 9 times out of 10, we don't have the time or the luxury for these applications to get in front of our commission as a whole. Fortunately, today we have 2 of them. They're not going to be heard today, but they are complete enough that we can have them to look at. And so now we can look at these as a commission, and as we agreed to, 3 or 4 months ago, Gretchen now is our lead person on this.
Right.
And Gretchen is going to be filling out our forms that are going to actually be sent, the one form that's going to be sent to the Planning Board. And so what I plan to do with these, once we get these things to review today, anybody have any issues, I'm going to get these to Gretchen, and Gretchen is going to fill out the forms, the form, and get it back to Karen. That's the process. 9 times out of 10, we don't have the luxury of everybody here looking at it.
Mm-hmm.
So when I get the application, Karen sends me what we should be looking at, and I get it over to Gretchen, and Gretchen fills it out.
Right.
But are you saying, Mike, that you're not getting those reports then?
I'm saying that the now look, I saw the jetty. I was part of the jetty.
Mm-hmm.
I was on the planning board when the jetty's first variance was reviewed, and we said no. Or actually, we went through that whole very, very long night.
Mm-hmm.
I don't recall anything being on the Environmental Commission's report. I could go back to my file and look and see, but I don't remember. I'm just saying that what happened was there was a document that showed every one of the variances that were reviewed, and that there were no Environmental Commission comments. And it was surprising. And again, the answer might be, but there really was nothing to comment on. However, Merrill has pointed out that there was a comment made on the jetty. And people were also thinking, geez, that jetty motel is right there near the piping plover, breeding area. I'm not sure how much that is a consideration, but maybe, you know, there should have been a comment that, extreme caution could be taken because, you know, only less than 100 yards away, piping plovers have a nesting ground. That's the kind of comment that they were expecting to see but didn't see. And all I need to do is go back and say, There's reasons for this.
Was there a Section 7 consultation with Fish and Wildlife Service?
I highly doubt it, but
that is consideration of any, that's any federal action.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't necessarily know if that's a city or a local government action that would impact a federally protected species.
It may just be a comment. This, you know, it's not like it has to be a condition.
That's all it can be, Mike, is a comment. Because
that's all it can
that's
be.
That's all it can be.
Yeah, that's all it can be. So my question to Gretchen was then, we have an issue with invasive species.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, at the very least, every time we're looking at a brand new home being built, I don't know why, if there is a variance requested, that's not always happening, but I said, I don't know why we can't just comment that, we would appreciate if the owners would be informed of invasive species that we would like for them to avoid. In the future, this commission hopes there's going to be an ordinance. I understand that. But in the meantime, I thought that maybe that would be something we'd comment on. But Gretchen thought if there's no ordinance in place, there's no sense in making the comment. I don't know. It's up to you guys whether or not that's
Gretchen sent you.
That's what you think.
Can I just ask a question because I'm new and I don't know? You get one copy from planning or zoning. One copy comes to the Environmental Commission, and then if we can, expected to look at it at one of these meetings.
Correct. Like we have two today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, listen. There's nothing. There's really not.
This would take.
That's impossible.
This would take.
No, it's not impossible. That's why we have Gretchen review it on behalf
okay,
of
us. Okay, so she does, okay.
And we don't do it.
But yeah, what if
and Gretchen said, even if there was just one or two more people that could help out
yeah.
when it's quick, maybe the whole commission cannot. You guys have a lot you want to discuss here. Mm-hmm. And I understand you don't want to be going through all of those at your meetings. But so Gretchen said, you know, maybe just
unofficially, I can't really make a real comment because I'm handling that.
Right.
I'm on the commission or the planning board.
And I think that's appropriate, Mike, that you.
Yes.
Go ahead, Jessica.
So would it be possible to have a copy of it distributed to each member?
I don't know whether we can. I don't know. Well, I don't.
They're huge.
Well, it's a I'm not sure how much of this can be a PDF.
A PDF.
Right. Mm. I don't know how much it can be.
Watch.
I mean, that's it.
Know. They're huge.
Yeah.
I
but
think that
can
there
we
are,
get
we
one
a subcommittee?
One,
we need a subcommittee that could come together.
Well, that was kind of the thinking.
Just a planning.
In the conversation that she and I had is just a small subcommittee that could be.
Yeah. Well, the only thing I can say, I'll talk to Gretchen that maybe, I mean, Gretchen's the lead person right now when in between meetings, okay? And she's really good at this. And if she's fine with touching base with several other people on the committee to have them come over quickly and look at it so she doesn't do it on her own.
Yes.
That's fine, but.
Yeah.
And she said she's got a meeting space right there at the National Center.
I was going to suggest that because not that, I mean, Gretchen's going to find everything probably and there's no reason for us not to be, but what if we do see something or what if we have some questions? And it seems to me that we should have an opportunity to at least meet separately, if for no other reason than to have Gretchen explain it to us, which obviously we cannot do by impossible. I meant, you know, we can't do it right here.
Right.
But there should be, I think, an opportunity for the rest of us to at least have a look at it.
Can she just email her comments or the our
concerns?
Her concerns, but also we have a very specific sheet to fill out.
There's a form that the planning that we have to submit to the planning board.
Right.
One page thing, and we submit whatever our concerns are.
And
gets PDF right to Karen at the zoning at the planning.
Yeah,
board.
Mm-hmm. But why can't it also before it goes to Karen, go to us so we can comment? Oh yeah, this is fine or not or whatever.
Listen, this has been a very fluid process.
Oh, I know. I've been here
I can only
a long
tell you
time.
If you want to go through that and do it.
Okay.
I mean that's a lot of work here for volunteers to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Evelyn,
yes.
There's only one copy that is put in the mailbox, and Karen lets me.
I know that. I know. I'm not asking for copies of that. I was asking for copies of the form.
Oh, Gretchen's
that Gretchen will
form.
Fill out.
If you haven't looked at the application, that form makes no sense to you to just see what Gretchen's
that's
comments
true.
Are.
That's
well, that's
true.
Why I think maybe it's not a bad idea to have. For Gretchen to have a couple of us, and maybe it varies from meeting to meeting, mm-hmm. to have a couple of us look at them. Not that I don't
I'm
trust Gretchen.
To,
nobody can not
the
trust
process,
her,
and I don't know whether
that would
that's
be
a
up
good
to Gretchen.
I don't know if that's
Mike and Mike.
Yeah.
Do we have engineers review these plans beforehand? Do they look
at the planning board? The planning board. Yes.
And then we have engineers look at the construction, look at the floodplain.
Yes,
look
all
at
that.
Yes.
Okay. And then other than...
Again, our Environmental Commission comments
right.
mm-hmm. on the application, all right?
All right. So now the application's vetted.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yes.
I mean, again, we're not engineers. I mean, we can only say this is what we think,
mm-hmm.
and then the planning board can take what we think and either act on it or not act on it, whatever they'd like, whatever their pleasure. Okay? But...
That's right. All right.
I don't... So this process we have right now is probably the best we've ever had it.
Okay. I'm not
best we've ever had.
I don't mean to criticize the process. I think it's fine, but then in some way, I guess maybe I'm asking if some way we could be informed about what's going. Gretchen did said something around, for example, about this new construction,
mm-hmm.
that she was concerned about the privet hedges and the lawn, and everybody got a copy of that. So maybe...
Well, I sent that out.
Or you did, I'm sorry.
She sent it out,
yeah.
sent it
only
to me
minutes.
Of concern,
right.
and I sent it out to you
right.
along with the seven-page list of plants for done by New Jersey Audubon,
right.
by Patricia Sutton, plantings to attract hummingbirds, butterflies,
Pat, yeah.
Pat Sutton.
Hmm?
Pat Sutton.
Well, we
well,
know...
Well, it says Patricia, so I just read what it says. Pat Sutton.
I understand that, and that's what I'm saying. If even that could come around to us, and maybe Gretchen's comments or questions or something, I'm not asking for the whole process. It's a very good process. I'm not criticizing that. But I'm feeling ignorant, you know. What are we talking about here?
Usually what we're looking at is... if they have a minor landscape plan, we look at that closely
mm-hmm.
and comment that don't use arborvitae, please use red cedar, that kind of
right.
thing. And also, I know that we have commented on floodplains.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure that
and like,
this is not dumped right into one.
And I can only tell you, planning board, I can't remember the last planning board we heard that had a question about a house. It's usually it's more
yes.
than that.
Right.
Yes.
Okay, so I mean
right.
I don't know what that's more a zoning board issue. Now, I don't know what
mm-hmm.
I don't know what the process is for the zoning board, but it took us a long time to get on the agenda at the environmental at the planning board.
Right.
And
right.
we're there now, which is a good
thing. Oh good. Yeah.
And you look very confused, because I am too.
I respect the process. I just think it would be great for each of us as members of the commission to know what's going on.
Well, again, it's all about timing, and I can't, like,
yeah.
when a person puts an application in front of the planning board, it could be a week before our meeting,
mm-hmm.
but like today, we have a planning board tonight, so they would hear it. Mm-hmm. We would have no time to actually make a comment because it's going to be on that, and that's why that's why we have Gretchen look at these things, and I'm sure Gretchen, if she's got some issues, she's going to write it down there.
Are we expecting her to review these two before tonight?
No.
Oh,
these were fortunate because these are going to be heard at next month's meeting.
Good.
But we have a chance today.
Yeah.
If you want to look at it and make a comment, that we
mm-hmm.
can do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but Gretchen, again, before they're going to be heard, she is going to actually write up the form and submit it. And that gets part of the
mm-hmm.
the resolution approving that or disapproving that application.
Mm-hmm.
It's part of that. It's part of that packet.
Yeah. Right.
So I don't know what means. So I would every planning board application that we've had, there should be something in there from the planning board.
Yeah, from the environmental commission.
I'm
sorry. Well, there. You know that there's a page there, and it's just.
Yeah,
there's no issues, and it's signed by
yeah.
the, you know.
I mean, they have the.
You haven't had a planning board meeting in a very long time.
No, we've had them pretty much every month now. But
now.
Like, those single page comments are they come from the fire department,
yep.
from the police department,
mm-hmm.
from the shade tree commission,
mm-hmm.
and from environmental commission.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So those are pretty much the four things, and they are actually part of the approval or disapproval of the application. All right, that's part
mm-hmm.
of the packet.
So those notes are getting into the packet then?
As far as I know, yeah. Because you'll see it's also as part of Craig's resolution to approve or disprove it. It's there subject to the comments of the Shade Tree Commission, the police
would there
department.
Be any way to establish some kind of environmental commission album that could be kept with these notes in it so that Mike, for example, wanted to just flip through it and see what we did say and do about each of these?
I suppose we could do that.
I mean, that's extra work.
Charlotte, you've been pretty quiet over there. You have any comments?
Well, I can just say that over the years, we as a commission have had a subcommittee look at the applications because
So this is interesting. I'm just pulling out the sheet that I was given.
Okay.
And this says Zoning Board of Adjustments. And what you're telling me is that you don't see the zoning board.
Not a lick. None.
Well, I don't know how you can comment if you don't get the zoning board.
No, it's the only thing. It took us probably 2 years to get in good stead with the planning board for our commission to make a comment.
So, well, this is interesting. So I have a pretty easy response when I go back to council and suggest that, well, if you want the Environmental Commission to comment on it, maybe you should let them know what the...
Again, I'm the liaison. We don't have a liaison to the zoning board.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. We don't.
So you're the...
And,
okay.
And believe it or not, that's probably where most of our problems would arise, only because of, like, usually it's like an addition to a house, and, mm-hmm. and that's where they would do the environment, where the right. plantings, and also that's probably where the most of it would take place.
Can we do something about that? Can we...
Sure. Well, I think we'll do something about that.
We should
as
request
I see
that
the
zoning board either
talk.
Send a liaison or whatever the process is, so that...
Sure, yeah. Charlotte. Go ahead. Thing. Go ahead.
For the good of the group, just remember that you, as an environmental commission, do an outstanding job. And you do it with very little professional help. We have a very competent secretary. We have a very competent chairperson. We have a very competent liaison.
My only, go ahead, you want to make another comment?
No, I just wondered if it's then possible for whatever the process is to have a liaison or some kind of contact with zoning as well as planning. What I don't know what that takes, probably.
Okay, we are, my only comments now, I guess, for the council would be that if they have any suggestions, bring it back.
That's exactly yeah. where it should be. So it's now my... you've answered the question. It's now my responsibility to try to make the connection that would be appropriate.
I mean, I've always felt everyone, you know, when people don't show up or don't do stuff, I keep thinking, well, you're all volunteers. I can't, it is what it is. You know, you do what you can.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely.
If you show up and you're really active, that's fine.
Yes.
And if you're not, that's fine too. All right.
So, and I'm just one more thing, just back to our original question about being able to see Gretchen's comments or talk to Gretchen or have a little mini meeting with Gretchen or something. Is that possible? Can we just do that informally
have to? This is what I would rather like to see you do. I mean, we entrusted with Gretchen to do this because, like I said, 9 times out of 10, we don't have the luxury of seeing that as a board, as a commission, I'm sorry.
Right.
So now, if I would think that if Gretchen has some being uncomfortable with something, then she would get back and reach out to somebody else.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But I don't think she's going to have that instance where she's going to say, you know, I really need help. But I know she's smart enough to know that if she would do it if she needed to.
Oh no, I have no doubt about that. I'm talking not so much about Gretchen's ability to do it, which is unquestioned. It's a question of our knowing about it.
Let's have a conversation with Gretchen next
sure.
when she's here.
Yeah, I think you should, because she indicated that a small group would be helpful to her.
I have a concern. For our commission meetings, we must abide by the Sunshine Law. I don't know if we can have subcommittees without the Sunshine Law, which is telling the papers when we're meeting.
As a commission, are we subject to Sunshine?
We are.
We've always had subcommittees, as long as it's not more than half. And
I think we should ask Aaron Burke.
Well, that's why, see, the issue with council people is mm-hmm. two of us can sit there and meet, three cannot, but that's because that constitutes a majority.
Okay.
So I believe you said it exactly like mm-hmm. right, Merle. Okay. If you have less than half of your members meeting, it does not constitute a meeting
okay.
and won't
okay.
violate sunshine okay. law.
Mike, I served for 15 years on the planning board, and I was on the zoning board for 3 years. I mm-hmm. had to give up the zoning board to take over the secretary of the commission. Can't do double dipping or whatever.
That's right. Right.
And worked through master plans with the planning board, and there were always subcommittee things that we met small groups to do a questionnaire or to do something and then prepare. So, you know, that's how yep. it worked.
Okay. A discussion for Gretchen.
For Gretchen, yeah.
Right, when
yeah.
Gretchen comes in next month, we'll have right. that. We'll just decide exactly how she wants yeah. to do it.
That's great.
Good.
Thank you.
I've done some construction planning, and this is a very complicated little.
They usually are. They usually yeah. are.
This is three properties in one plan.
Well, I haven't looked at the app yet.
And
I'm just saying.
There is no landscaping, so.
It's Lafayette, Pittsburgh, and Harbor Cove, wherever Harbor Cove is.
That's a problem application right now.
I think that one you aren't going to believe that's going to get complex because I believe he's trying to make a
that's
swap.
That's the Di Donato application.
Yes. Yes.
And I can tell it has to deal with COA issues.
Yes.
With COA,
affordable housing.
He built
one
of them.
I read that.
A duplex. And he's noting it in there.
From memory now, I haven't really looked yes. at this thing, but
no, you're right.
We approved him as an applicant. He has, I think, he has the right to put the affordable housing on site, or he could apply to have it off site.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So there's issues there with what we approved,
right.
and now what he wants to do.
Right. Affordable housing in Cape May.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Well, I was looking at their money things, and they're saying that mortgages of $88,000 and $100,000.
Those applications aren't tonight, and I'm not worried.
Okay.
About it.
Okay. That will not
All right.
happen here.
Subject
right.
one done.
So I'm good. Thank you.
Yeah.
Right. Yes. Whatever My job
we
now.
Back, whatever we whatever.
Okay.
Whatever
you okay? You Over there.
We have. There's Mara wanted me to bring up. We put in an ad in the paper, correct?
Ta-dum.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, now there's a question of payment. We got to make sure it gets paid.
Oh, come on.
Charlotte's our consultant, and Gretchen worked on this ad because it had to go in immediately because Earth Day. And I worked with the Star and Wave as far as the actual size of it and coming up with the price.
Yeah.
And
it's actually in the paper.
He needed... approval, so I approved it, and he is sending me the bill for $291, which is a very reasonable cost for that, and then I was going to pass it on to the city manager.
Yes.
And it's part of our educational effort, and it came out really good. And so hopefully Mike will make a motion and.
Motion for it. Somebody will make a motion, but we have to pay
somebody,
for it.
Yes.
Somebody has
Is
to pay for it.
I'll make a motion to pay from our budget.
Correct.
Yes.
Second?
I'll second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All right, so that's, you have now the authority
right,
to do
but
that.
All right, but the other request is that we have it printed once a month through the summer.
And that would be at the same cost?
At the same cost, which is $291 and a little bit of change.
May I make a suggestion? I understand the length of it for Earth Day, you know, including a lot more information is valuable, but for something that is a recurring ad in the paper. I think something with less text
yeah.
would be more digestible for a broader range of audience. I saw it.
Okay.
Or split it. Do one yeah. part one time and one you know, part. You're right, because people won't read
people
it.
People are going to just
they won't read it
over it and not read it. So that's my
suggestion. I like that.
If we do July, June, July, and August, you can split that. Three ways in whatever way seems best.
Even bullet points
yeah.
instead of block paragraphs.
Yeah, there's too many.
Draw people
we
in.
We used to do public safety announcements.
Yeah.
And they were very small mm-hmm. and bulleted. We can go back to that.
Just a suggestion.
Would
I am
you
not
like
a
to do that?
I'm happy to be involved in whatever capacity you'd like. It's just a suggestion. Mm-hmm.
All right, so why don't you, this is a hard copy of it.
Okay.
So, Justina, look at it and put something together that you think,
sure.
and I'm not sure who actually
you,
has the
Yeah,
the software
send me the
for that.
Computer file so that I have the actual images and can play with that as opposed to retyping everything.
Oh, I'll send you what I have.
Okay.
The Storm Wave did put those two pictures in.
Yep.
From their files.
Starn Ripple?
Huh?
Starn Ripple?
Yeah.
sorry.
Okay.
Can I add some humor into this meeting?
I'm sorry.
I have to add some humor into this meeting. It's called the Starn Ripple around here. Not the Starn.
I've
never heard
long
that.
Enough to know
so
that.
You'll just,
sorry.
I've never
I've
heard
only
that.
Got 50 I mean, years in.
Me too. 27. Never heard it. It's funny.
Cut it in half.
Yeah.
yeah.
Just simple.
Just,
all right,
just
so
kidding.
We're going to put some ad in
yeah.
once a month.
Let's see what that.
Yes.
Let's see what the ad is going
okay.
to look like.
I will try to have it to you by the end of the weekend. How about that? So we can keep the ball rolling.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
So the same size ad, or are you going to reduce the?
Well, I think she.
You could cut it to quarter page if you reduce the text and the graphics.
Yeah, just so it's
well,
not, yeah.
Decided that we didn't want to pack it in too much, wanted the white
right.
space so that
yeah.
it didn't look so forbidding.
Well, but that's the point. With this much text, it isn't so forbidding as it is ignorable. So if you cut the text, and I don't know, I would leave the pictures in because that's what's attractive. But if you cut the text a little bit, you can still have that same visual impact without so many words.
Yeah, just like the preposition.
Well, Justine's going to work on it and figure out
right.
what we, the
yep.
Environmental Commission,
see
would
what
like
I come
to.
Up with. No problem.
Okay.
Actually,
yeah,
at
that's
that
fine.
Point, at that point, once you get something, you could email a PDF to everybody and they
yeah.
make
yeah.
comment on
Com-
it.
Comments.
Yeah,
sure.
That's good.
Absolutely.
Okay. And at that point, if we'd like that, then we could put that in for the next month.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll move on. We'll decide after that what we want.
This was done between Gretchen and Charlotte on a very short time.
No, it's fine.
No.
There's nothing
we're,
wrong with it.
We're going to improve it.
Yeah,
so
it's fine.
We're all volunteers. Remember that?
Yeah. I don't ever forget.
No.
Except for you.
Okay. What else on the as far as the agenda? We next month we're going to have hopefully that speaker back, Lisa. Hopefully.
From the.
The Haskins Shellfish Research Laboratory.
Mm. On Pittsburgh?
So it's up in Bivalve.
Oh, she's in Bivalve.
Yeah, so she works with Rutgers. She confirmed to come today and canceled like last week.
I'm interested to learn about their oyster research and.
It's a really neat place.
It yeah. is.
It's amazing what they're doing. Not only are they rehabilitating the. The species population, but she also has information on how oysters kind of as a technology can be used to clean waterways.
Yeah.
yeah.
So potentially well, something we could implement
yeah.
down the road.
Delaware
here.
Was one of the historic, well, they call it bivalve
yeah.
for one reason. Delaware was the biggest
yeah.
oyster and more millionaires lived along the Delaware Bay shore than in Cape May.
There's a really good book that the Bay Shore, I'm not going to remember the full name, the Bay Shore Museum has put out on the history of the Meerwald, and it goes into all of this.
The Meerwald, yeah.
Yeah. so.
Talking about money here. Our budget, we are for the $5,000?
The $5,000 approved, it's there.
Okay.
The request was made for the $1,000 check.
For Gretchen.
Yeah, I actually thought that it would be in my inbox today, and but Mike, he submitted it.
Okay.
Last week.
That's fine.
You know, you go through a little bit of a process here, so.
As long as that's.
I'll make sure it gets to Gretchen. If they don't mail it to her,
so
if I get it, I'll get it to her.
And the $291 for the ad we have to pay, and whatever we're going to be paying for the next ad. So that's where we stand, paying for money. If there's any other ideas that people want to.
And we're all volunteers.
I have one more.
I'm just kidding.
Go ahead. No, we're not done yet. Anybody, did you have another?
I'm an appointed member of the Cape May Green Team, the City Green Team.
Mm-hmm.
And so, with the flower show coming up at Convention Hall, there is this idea, having talked to Gretchen as well, about the kinds of Environmental Commission / Green Team, City of Cape May, letting people know that we advocate for wildlife. So these seeds will be distributed free to anyone who comes into the flower show. And we've gotten an okay to have a chair there to pass these out. So just wanted to let you know that we're trying to let people know about the types of plants that will encourage butterflies, birds, and bees in their gardens with the distribution of these various seeds.
Charlotte, the date on that?
14th.
May 14th.
14th, Saturday.
Do we have any... Charlotte, do we have any... We have to... get some money for that? How's that being covered, do you know?
That's being covered.
Okay, all right.
No.
No?
It's Garden Club?
By private.
It's probably free.
Okay.
No, private donation.
Right.
Anybody else have any comments? Chris?
I'm sorry, I was not on mic, but I was just asking, that's done by a private donation? That's very nice.
Yes, private donation.
Who's going to be manning the booth?
So it can be, any member could sit with this.
I'll man the booth.
Chris has volunteered to.
What date?
May 14th.
Saturday, May 14th.
I'm on the Garden Club, and so I'll take a turn. They don't let us out.
I'll man the booth with you.
How about Merle? You take the lead on that. If somebody needs,
I'll organize.
If they need help, if they need help, just organize.
Look at me. I could do.
All come to the flower show every. Anyway, it's lovely. Trust me.
Convention Center.
Convention Hall, May 14th, starts at 1.
Starts at 1?
Speaking
I can't remember. No, I'll be there.
I'll let you know what the time slots are.
Okay, Justine wants to make a comment here.
Sounds like we're wrapping that up, so I want to pivot. Speaking of Environmental Commission tables, the table at the Ocean Festival needs to be organized, and I was at the planning meeting for that event.
The Ocean Festival on Pittsburgh?
At the Nature Center.
Nature Center.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's the date on that?
June
11th.
And actually, we were both there, right. And I was asked to help plan the Environmental Commission table. And I think it would be great to work with someone else on the commission to put that together.
I will.
Great. Okay. So
okay.
This all-day event?
Yes.
And there's...
We could switch off, couldn't we?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Wonderful. So why don't the three of us connect via email? We can put some ideas together. Do you want to join?
I live two blocks away.
Great.
Yeah.
So we'll get started on that this week. It's, I mean, just 6 weeks away, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
And
I had one other
go
question.
Ahead.
Sorry.
Nothing wrong.
Who in the city, which city employee or department is in charge of IV remediation on government property?
let's have an IV conversation.
There are multiple trees in the city park that will die very soon if it's not removed.
I think I said this the last time, having suddenly become aware of how, and not knowing, I knew before, but has suddenly come aware how ubiquitous ivy is. It's like kudzu. It is everywhere. And you're just talking about the park, everywhere in
Mike,
the city.
Mike, do you think if she touched base with who's the guy's at Public Works?
Eric Pruszynski.
Then Eric would ultimately
Public
get in
Works.
Touch with somebody in the city.
It would be Eric's employees that would do it. I mean, they take care of all the plantings, maintenance of the parks
Work.
And the like.
Right, okay.
The and if it's, yeah, if it is in a park especially.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just look right across the street at the neighbor's house, and I can't believe. Yeah.
It's unbelievable, really, when you start looking.
Oh, it is terrible. It's like
I think
just
you're
watch
be
it
on
die.
You're going to be on next month.
Watch
I
it
thought.
Die.
So the city needs.
We're informally on this month, if there's
yeah.
time.
Maybe we can salvage it.
Right.
It's okay. worth a try.
That's all we can do.
Yeah.
Okay, we have another last-minute agenda item. Evelyn, you want to send?
No, not right.
It was informal, but it will, right, if there's time.
The ordinance, we're trying to get through for to get rid of the invasive species, and we have been trying for months. I unfortunately was not at the meeting when they threw it out. They voted no. I don't know why. And you aren't there.
I was not a member then.
I think it was. The objection was, and we addressed it a couple of months ago. It was like the first week I was here. The objection was invasion of privacy. Right. And we rewrote the rewrite to include the phrase from Street View. So that would prevent people from wandering into other people's backyards and checking their ivy or whatever. And we thought that might have addressed it. And the other thing that we changed was to, in the original or one of the original ordinances, it said something about designated inspectors. I forget the phrase right now, but it was something like that. And we wanted to change that or alter that in some way so that members of the Environmental Commission could be designated as reviewers, inspectors, whatever the word is. And I'm sorry, I don't have the legal words in front of me. So that we would have some kind of authority to say 1146 Washington Street is being, that's my next door neighbor, is being overgrown by ivy. And report to whomever is then in authority to do something about it. And that, I think those were just the alterations we made. But the objection, I think, from City Council was that privacy issue, which I think we addressed when we said from Street View. And since then, we've sort of tossed it back and forth, but for a variety of reasons, I think it hasn't gone anywhere. But at some point, it needs to go to City Council.
Yeah, I hope addressed noted it. That the Mosquito Commission has the ability and the allowance to go into your backyard. They come in and look at puddles and then tell you how to get rid of them.
I think only if you request.
Yeah, they have to knock on your, they knock on you, they ask permission.
Okay, yes. Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. We don't have a whole lot of authority. We have advisory authority, and that's it.
Right.
So I also amended this, I listed the Dirty Dozen, and I listed URLs for, and the Do Not Plant list is huge. So there was no reason to put it in here but to reference it. Most of the plants referenced in the Do Not Plant are, they plant themselves in the woods. They're not, most of them are not plants that you would ever plant. You would never choose to plant.
True.
But there are some. The purple loosestrife, I've noticed, has decreased in our city. I made up a little, several years ago, made up a brochure of a please don't plant this beautiful plant. And I would, when I took a walk, I would put it in people's doorways if they had one. And I've contacted all of the landscapers that I knew did work around here and sent them the brochure and asked them, please don't plant it. So I think it's getting less and less. But Mike, I would like this to go to the council as first read, please.
So
let's get it moving.
Yeah.
It the best way to go about it would probably be for somebody from this commission to do another presentation to council.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, what I can do is ensure that or assure the council members that what the commission wants to come back with is something different from the original, and we believe that it overcomes their objections.
Hopefully.
So we'd like to have somebody from the commission come and review what the proposal is, and I'm sure that they'd be willing to do that. So let me talk
to.
So
this is what you think we ought to present?
Mm-hmm.
I would like to see side by side what was denied.
Well, we have that.
I'd like to see that.
Sure.
Tonight. So I want to see the differences, okay. What they're going to see.
That's exactly what I'd feel more comfortable with.
I would too.
Seeing
absolutely.
Too. I want to.
Yeah,
know
we
the
have
differences.
That. Well, then we'll sit down and work on that, and if can then we would be since we've been working on that, I guess we would be the ones to make the presentation to city council.
Yeah, Hope and I will. Right. We'll attend,
and we'll find all the find all the old ones and the ones that we've revised, and we can get it all to you.
I'll find the one that was alive in December, and I'll send it to Merrill, okay? Because she can send
before
it
you
out.
Get before you get in front of council. I think we as a commission ought to go over.
Okay.
It.
Okay.
Oh, sure.
Oh, so you're saying don't
absolutely
that's right. Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet.
So and we have. Has anybody looked at what Sea Isle, was it Sea Isle?
There's a bunch of
yeah,
stuff
we
out
looked
there.
At,
send it out.
We've looked at all of them.
I mean,
do you know how many
you have that
okay.
little bit
we
of...
We have several models, and they're all essentially the same.
Okay.
The words are different. The one from...
Other people have done it. I mean, it's not like...
Right.
Crazy.
One of them is very, very long.
We looked at all of them.
Long, but they're all essentially the same thing.
Right.
Evelyn, I know you've done a lot of work on this thing. Don't get me wrong.
I'm sorry.
I just want to make
sure. No, you're absolutely right.
I want to see what was denied, and
yes,
I want to see
I
exactly
what
we're going to give them.
It's all right here in the folder. We'll be happy to do that.
It might make sense to have a visual component.
Yeah.
Puts the two side by side with the highlighted changes.
Oh, you mean the two,
that they're not
you denied this and
yeah.
this is how
so
we changed
yeah.
it?
Listening
sure.
to it, they
okay.
can see it.
There's some strong language in here, though.
Yes.
That's why I want to
yes,
wanna
there is.
Sure I want to, then I'm going to compare it to what other places approved
okay.
how they didn't mm-hmm. or didn't.
Some other places are much stricter and
yeah.
much larger than what we've
okay.
done. Others have done almost minimal.
I'm sorry.
Chris, go ahead. What?
What was your comment? I'm sorry.
How are we enforcing this strong language?
Yes, the cost of abatement shall be borne by the property owner. I mean that.
It is, and we decided that if the property owner does nothing, the city will remove it and bill him or her. With
so do we.
And
this is typical.
This is existing. This is existing
yeah.
planting.
I don't
yes.
know. I don't know
yeah.
this stuff.
Yeah. yeah, this is typical of the several other ordinances we've looked at. Some are a little less lenient. Some are even stricter.
More. Yeah. More
okay.
rigid than
okay.
we have.
And I think we have all the other ordinances.
Oh, yes.
As them, so.
Yes, somewhere.
Once you give me, once we get the old one and the new one, then we can just sit down and at the next meeting, we'll go over it hard.
Which old one would you like?
What?
They're like, I'm serious. There are four or five of them.
I was going to say.
The last one.
There's the most recent one that was rejected, right?
The latest old one that was rejected.
Right, the latest old one. Right.
Okay.
That's fine.
Okay.
And I'll put this on the agenda for the next meeting.
That'd be fine.
Send me the stuff.
I will.
I'll send it out.
Okay.
Okay.
And then
we'll talk
about it next meeting, and then we'll make a plan for when you're going to present it.
No, I'll look at the hard.
And I sent this around. This was Gretchen's copy of all the invasives forever, this whole thing.
Oh, that's past.
And this is the one that they use, and I did give it to a copy of this to Haberman, because they, who was our landscaper, and he was going to start putting some trees in for us where we had the shade permission to, et cetera. So I gave him a copy, and he said he put it on his desk.
Oh, good.
They still sell Barberry at every...
Yes, everywhere. Yeah. I just saw it in what I had thought until recently was a very good garden catalog.
Anyway,
I
can only do what I can do.
No? Right, let's wrap it up. Anybody else have anything they want to say? Charlotte, you want to say anything?
Public.
Oh, yeah, I did too.
And they were going to make comments endorsing council's idea to have the police department cited, I believe it's St. John Street, is that right?
Correct.
Yes. Yeah.
That's correct.
Good idea.
That would be very much appreciated. Mm-hmm.
S-I-G-H-T-E-D or not C-I-T-E-D? Cited or cited?
I didn't quite.
Discussed.
The cops are going to have a place to live.
That's correct.
S-I-T-E-D.
Okay.
That's the site that they want to put it on.
Okay. When you say police department, cited, to me that means... It means a different thing.
Any idea, Mike, when they might have a plan on that, a site plan available?
The site plan is already sort of sketched out.
Public?
I mean, they have
public review yet?
Not until this swap is done.
Yeah, okay. Right.
And so the first meeting, we've had a task force kind of get-togethers, but not the entire group just yet. The first meeting is going to be, how do we get this plot exchange done? We need deeds. We need deeds exchanged. And so I don't think it'll take that long as we get the support of people. I mean, it was a good meeting here, but there weren't many people.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was positive. People can be writing in. It would be great for people to write in and just say, we support this exchange of land. How can you help but give 5 acres to the Green Acre site over there? It's like, it's so perfect in exchange.
Is it west of the church? I mean, toward the beach?
What's that? Oh, no, I believe it's farther away. It's this
closer
other
to
end.
The development.
I believe it's this.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the northern.
Less wetlands issues,
yeah.
I
yeah.
think. Okay.
So, anyhow, its first order of business is get this thing done, and then everybody will see the layout.
Okay, motion to adjourn.
To the move.
Public.
Open to the public?
It was also suggested to me that the Environmental Commission make a statement of support for the solar power being integrated onto the city buildings. That suggestion came from someone on council, and I think that it would be a great thing for us to do. You know, it's like sending a great message to the community.
Mm-hmm. On this building?
Yes. No, no. I mean, new, all city buildings.
All city buildings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's kind of timely, but
I know there is some banter going back and forth about that at the last meeting. What, any idea how that's left?
We approved it.
Okay.
We approved it because the concern was that you would see the panels from the from
HPC
the ground.
HPC signed off?
It was going to the HPC, but I'm okay. I think they had already pretty much. You won't see the panels.
I know.
They're
I'm
below
looking up,
the,
what are we
the level
about
of the parapets up there. So
maybe we could draft something.
I think it's a done deal.
Yeah, but it would be great for the community to see that the Environmental Commission
put it in the minutes, and we approve it.
Well, I have to say that we approved that and endorsed it probably 15 years ago.
Here we are.
Lifeguard station, and then certainly after that, the Nature Center, and certainly after that, at the desal plant, and all municipalities. Actually, we have a resolution in place endorsing it, and we were the ones who proposed this at least 15 or 20 years ago.
Isn't that amazing?
So it's in place.
Do we know if the new firehouse is going to have solar panels?
It will not.
Why?
I'm not sure I can recall. There was a reason, a very good reason, and it might be visibility. If you look at the design, my recollection is that it does have slope roofs on,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And HPC wouldn't have been crazy about it. So it's probably going to be one of the only buildings that won't have it. But yeah, so this building will, and the desal plant, we need a new desal plant, and I'm pretty sure that there will be a field of solar panels out there, because that consumes a whole lot of electricity. But yes, Charlotte's right. That's a perfect location for more solar panels.
I mean, the new firehouse is not historic, so
the design is.
It's the orientation's not exactly
not right. I understand
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
I mean, it would be the. Yeah, the roof facing the ocean, and yeah, it could be seen.
Yeah,
but
I think they're
the
pretty, but I'm
and
in
the
minority.
Cost benefit of putting solar and the efficiency is like you gotta marry those two up, and it's.
And we haven't done that very well yet.
No, because the efficiency of solar panels are.
That's improving all the time, though. I
mean, they are.
I just saw mm-hmm. something yesterday. It's improving immensely fast.
Mm-hmm. I think the newer, although they're expensive, but the newer, quote, solar panels look like a roof shingle.
Yeah.
But they're expensive.
That's what I'm putting on my home.
That kind, yeah. I have the old ones, the big old glass panels.
Okay, Mike.
All right.
Yep. Okay.
I think so. You only 3 minutes over, Mike.
Doing good. I'll do better next time.
All
right. All right. Off with your mics, everybody.
Oh. All right. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
All right.
It's so nice.